Hi, today we are going to discuss some important geometrical results of a circle. Suppose if there is a circle and a line, how many ways they can exist in a plane? Suppose circle S is equal to 0 and a line L is equal to 0 exist in this way, or the circle and line intersect may intersect each other, or the line touches the circle at one point. In all those cases, we have to relate them. Here, if P is the perpendicular distance, let us assume that S is equal to 0 be the circle, S is equal to 0 be a circle, and R is the radius of the circle. The radius is equal to R, and if P is the perpendicular distance from center of the circle to the line, if P is equal to perpendicular distance from center of circle to the line. Center of circle to the line. Then, based on these positions, here if you observe that, here the distance, perpendicular distance is P in the first case. If you again consider this line and the circle is center with C, this is line L is equal to 0, and in this position may exist, or in this position may exist. Here the line distance, the distance from center to the line is P. It is less than radius. Radius is the distance from the second line. Here the line touches the circle. Means here to here the distance is equal to radius. And in the third case, the perpendicular distance, the circle to the center to the line, in third case P greater than radius. So three cases existed. Case 1, P is less than radius. In that case, the circle, the line and circle intersect in two distinct points. And in the second case, the line and circle intersect each other. So in the second case, case 2, what is case 2? The line touches. If P is equal to R, then the line L is equal to 0 be a tangent to the circle. Tangent to the circle. In third case, case 3. In case 3, what happens? The perpendicular distance from center to the line, perpendicular distance P, is greater than radius. Means the circle and the line exist in this manner. It is greater than its radius. Radius means here to here the length, the boundary, but the given line L is equal to 0, somewhat more. So in this case P greater than R. So the line in this case do not intersect, do not touch. They are separate from one another. The line L is equal to 0, S is equal to 0, separate each other. These are the three possible cases for a line and circle. Suppose, based on this concept, let us do one problem. That is question number 1. Suppose x minus 1 whole square plus y minus 2 whole square is equal to 64. it is a circle. And x plus y minus 4 is equal to 0. So find out whether the line and the circle touch each other or intersect, whether the line and circle touch each other or not. Or not. So what should we do? In this case, the circle, if you observe the circle, x minus 1 whole square plus y minus 2 whole square is equal to 8 square. Center of the circle is 1, 2, and the radius of the circle is 8 in this case. And moreover, given line is x plus y minus 4 is equal to 0, given line. So if you see, the perpendicular distance P from center 1, 2 to the line, using the formula ax1 plus by1 plus c by root over a square plus b square, it is the distance, perpendicular distance. Is equal to perpendicular distance means P is equal to what happens? P is equal to AX1 means 1 into 1 plus B means 1, 2 minus 4 by root of 1 square plus 1 square. P is perpendicular distance equal to what about the perpendicular distance now? Is equal to 1 plus 2 minus 4. 3 minus 4, 1 by root 2. This is the perpendicular distance. What about the radius? But r is equal to p is equal to 1 by root 2 and r is equal to 8. Here clearly what happens? R is greater than p. Therefore, the line intersects the circle in two distinct points. P is less than r. Therefore, it is intersecting the circle in two distinct points. This is the position of line. So next result is